I'm going to share with you the ultimate guide to subnetting shortcuts. This session is meant to introduce you to the how of subnetting, but not necessarily the why at this time. With this process, you can subnet any address, and you will not need to memorize anything. Here are some of the things that you'll be working with. First, we need to have the bits borrowed. This value is either given to you in a problem, or you can calculate it. Next, the bits left are either given or calculated. For a Class C license, which you remember is in the network host format, you will have only that last octet to play with, so the bits left are 8 minus the bits borrowed. For a Class B license, which is in the network host format, you will have the last two octets to play with, so the bits left are 16 minus the bits borrowed. For a Class A license, which is in the format network host, you will have the last three octets to play with so that the bits left are 24 minus the bits borrowed. Now that you know the bits borrowed and the bits left, you can determine the number of networks or subnets that can be created. That is 2 raised to the power of the bits borrowed, so 2 to the bits borrowed. The number of hosts per subnet is 2 raised to the bits left, or 2 to the bits left. The next two values you need to know are the subnet mask and the increment value. The increment value is the key to solving any subnetting problem. Let's look at the table. The top row is made of the powers of 2. The second row is the powers of 2 expanded. The third row is what I call the subnet mask row. The subnet mask is determined by looking at the table. Once you know the bits borrowed, you can start at the left of the table and count over the bits borrowed. So let's say we have 3 bits borrowed. I start at the left of the table, count over 3 columns, and I circle the column that says 2 to the 5th, 32, and 224. Lori's circle shortcut states that once you circle that column, the number on the bottom is the one you'll use in the value of your subnet mask, and the number of the top, second row, is your increment value. You'll use that increment value to find the network address for the subnets. What octet do you add that increment value to? Well, that's based on the number of bits borrowed. Class C, it's going to be the last octet. Class B, it'll either be the third or fourth octet. If you borrowed 2 to 8 bits, it's going to be the third octet. If you borrowed 9 to 14 bits, it'll be the fourth octet. For Class A license, it's going to affect either the second, third, or fourth octet. If you borrowed 2 to 8, it's going to affect the second octet. If you borrowed 9 to 16, it's going to affect the third octet. If you borrowed 17 to 22, it's going to affect the fourth octet. But you don't have to memorize all that. Basically, whatever the last non-zero octet is in the subnet is the corresponding octet that you add the increment value to in order to find the network address of the subnet. Remember, you have to borrow at least 2 bits and leave at least 2 bits anytime you're subnetting. If you don't, it just doesn't work out mathematically. Try it if you don't believe me. Confused? Don't worry. You can play this audio again, or just move on to the example of working out a problem using this technique. You will get it with a little practice and patience.